Hi, this is Andy Farke. I'm the director at the Raymond M. Alf Museum of Paleontology at the Webb Schools, and I am so excited to share my reactions to the Prehistoric Planet official trailer. Of course, I'm a dinosaur paleontologist, so seeing the Mesozoic brought to life is really cool. So let's take a look and see, what I think of it as we go. Wow, here we are on the beach. Wonder if this is the Western Interior Seaway in North America. Cool, marine life, aquatic life. Oh wow, look at that integument. Oh, fantastic Asdarchids. Look at that. Wow. So I'm going to pause it right here. You know, I'm contractually obligated as a paleontologist to pause for the dromaeosaurs, the raptor type things. I just got to say that the reconstructions that I've seen so far in another promo material are absolutely gorgeous. This is really, like, as a paleontologist, if I were to imagine what a real live dinosaur or other Mesozoic animal looked like, you know, these things just look so good. The production quality on this is amazing, not just from the scientific accuracy, which is really, very few quibbles with that, but also just like how good, how real these things look. I would say I haven't, seen this quality of effects, in a television or streaming program, maybe since the original Walking with Dinosaurs, 20 years ago plus. So this is really cool. It's even, I would say it exceeds, some things that are out there or coming out in the movie theaters nowadays. Wow, swimming Tyrannosaur. Cool, oh, and little babies. So, wow. So I will say, like, there's a little too much roaring for my taste, but I know that, we got to have that. But I love, beyond the roaring, the way they're showing these other behaviors, these other actions and attitudes for animals here. Animals, sitting on a beach, just hanging out. I love this one here, our Dinochirus, it's a great way to introduce everyone, maybe that's not, in the dino nerd world, to the way that this mysterious animal, now is known to look. I love the integument, the feathery type structures. I love the way they've given the face patterning and texturing, the keratin and all of that. It just looks really, really great, and to see behavior, that's not just things, flashing their menacing claws around, but actually like chowing down on, whatever plants are in the water. This just looks fantastic, and I think it really gives a true picture of, what it might have been like to see these animals as live animals. Wow, big sauropods, cool. Oh, I love this. And I love that they're, just to back up a second, I love that there is a, they're showing, some different life stages, and really accurate, really well done showing, what things look like from the fossils. So this one's going to, probably be a little controversial for some people, showing, the quills or feather, quill type things on ceratopsians. I, as a ceratopsian worker, like, I don't know how I feel, it's like not great evidence for it, but there's not, anything's possible. There's just a lot we don't know. And I think it's certainly, in the realm of possibility. But it is cool to see, the way they've shown dinosaurs in all the environments that they lived in. This is cool. This is one that's, I know freaking a lot of people out, showing the little air sacs along the neck of a big sauropod dinosaur. Again, like, I don't care. It's in the realm of possibility. Modern animals, whether they're birds, lizards, mammals, whatever, they do all some really weird things with, pneumatics and air sacs and all that. So this is cool. Do we have evidence that this happened? Nothing direct, but it's certainly in the realm of possibility. And I like that, this is showing some imaginative, but, things that aren't, completely, out of left field. Yeah, lots of music. Nice sweeping music. These little guys are just so cute, these little ornithischians. I love that they're shown, you know, kind of as like little pudgy. And a lot of times dinosaurs are drawn, you know, very, very sleek, almost, you know, a little too skeletal. And I love that this is showing some views that, you know, first showing some interesting behavior in terms of these things, you know, kind of edging their way out across a log. But also I love that they're showing, you know, kind of the range of body shapes that, you know, living animals have that, you know, could very well have been seen in dinosaurs. This scene is great. Okay, I know it's another Tyrannosaur, but I love, you know, this kind of behavior shown. Again, hey, look, a Tyrannosaur that's not roaring with its mouth open. I love that, and I love the way that there's personality to the animals in terms of, you know, that looks like the scarring on the leg of one of them. That just so cool. Really showing these things as living animals, not just monsters. And the textures are so gorgeous. This is cool. Yep, Mosasaurus. Great, see that? Love this. Yep. Something I find really interesting in a lot of this is the way that, you know, some of these scenes are like directly, you know, referencing, as near as I can tell, you know, some fairly well-known paleontological art pieces in terms of some of the colors, some of the scenes that are shown. And I'd really, really love the dynamism, you know, the dynamic notion here. And also, you know, looking at this, like this little Triceratops, this baby Triceratops, certainly I think one of the first, maybe not the first, but one of the first portrayals of this life stage of animals. And also it's really pretty well done in terms of showing what we know now about how the little guys looked. So this is really cool. Yep. All right. Okay. That one was a little too, George Lucas, you know, I'm just having flashbacks to some of the stuff in some of the Star Wars prequels. There we go, little animals down below. But, you know, that's okay. Okay, sorry for Triceratops. But, wow, really phenomenal. You know, anything I would say... Cool. You know, I could be cynical. I could, you know, make snarky commentary about a lot of this, but, you know, it's hard to do so. Like, there's so much I'm excited about to see with this. You know, I know it's going to be speculative in areas, but I also know that it's going to, you know, portray a lot of facets of prehistoric life that haven't necessarily been portrayed or haven't been portrayed as well to a broad audience. So for that reason, you know, yes, this is not, you know, a literal nature documentary. It's a reconstruction of a prehistoric world, one version of a prehistoric world. But I think it's really going to bring a lot of exciting science to new audiences. And I'm so excited to share all of that as a scientist, as someone who communicates with the public. I'm really excited to share this with people out there in the world. Have fun.